Okay, let's have another demonstration how to do test-driven development. So here our task is to build some kind of a body mass index calculator, but first we want to create those tests. So let's just create a new test package here. Now we have the test here, and on the actual source code we have only main class, which has nothing in it. We don't need these, and we are not testing the main itself, but let's see, we want to test test body mass calculator, and what we want to do is to test, does it calculate correct values, and how does it work with the values that it should never get? Let's say your mass is negative, or your height is something like 4 meters, which is way too much. These kind of cases. So let's call the class PME calc. And this kind of a system is required, and then we can utilize its value method. It has two methods. First one returns the index value, body mass index, which is a floating point or double number, and the other method returns some kind of a textual presentation of the body mass index. So now we have the object, then we can just basically test it with the what we want to do is to get okay, now we need to do some sort of calculation. So if we have a body mass, what would be the body mass index if we have a 80 kilogram person, it's divided by 1.8. So it's 24.7. Let's say that the return value is with one decimal only. So 24.7, and we are using this BMI. Get body mass index. Let's consider it as a float. No, let's use double. And we are giving values 80 kilograms and 1.8 meters. Now it should return 24.7. And then let's try with some other values. Let's try with 100 kilograms and 1.9. Now we need to once again check the what is the correct value. So is 27.7. Okay. And then we should test test it with incorrect values. So we are putting weight minus 50 kilograms. That should return error, which is here presented as minus 1. And then we put height negative, and once again it should return minus 1. And then there is another function. We test it also, so message, and we are giving the same same numbers, and then we get back textual presentation. So it's 24.7, so that means it's basically it's normal weight now. And if we test it with only 60 kilograms, let's see what should be the So this can be normal or underweight. So let's put 58 here. So then it's underweight. And then of course, if we put very very heavy guy there, 160 kilograms, and 160 kilograms divided by 1.8 seconds is 49. So it's very severely obese. So we should get these kind of values with this this. So we are now creating a class which should have two methods which are returning double values, or then just some kind of a string. And this string comes from Wikipedia. There is this list of these textual presentations. So let's add new class, which should now be the BMI calc. Okay, and here we have it. Private weight, and let's expect that we are just mass. These are integer values, of course, they could be something, double values, but in this case it's enough that we are using them as integer values. There was only to the default constructor, so we can create it by pressing Alt and Insert. Let's create a construction. Its default value does nothing there. So, and then we need those methods. First, let's get this one. It's return double, and it should get two int values, mass as and yes, this should be integer 2. And now we can do the calculation. Like this. And let's see how is this working then when we are testing it. Okay, this is short, and then we have this second thing, and this is returning string messages. And it was also getting mass and height like this. And it should have the string value. And it should be returned. Okay, and now we need to get something, some kind of a textual presentation here. So if okay, we need also the body mass index, which we can use like this. Those use the other method to get the if BMI is less than 18.5, then we can say that the string is underweight, then the second thing here, and so if the body mass is less than 20 y 20 5, then this is normal, and if it's less than 30, then there is overweight, and we need a few more here. And guess what? This else if is not the best solution here, but let's go with that. And finally, if we have a body mass more than 20-40, then we have this very severe. Okay. And do I have something wrong? Yeah. There was colon, which is not the correct one. Yes, now we have two functions. The first one returns the body mass index double, and the second one returns textual presentation, and we have some kind of a error thing. So if those masses and other things are not correct, then we should return -1. So let's test. No, let's yeah. Okay, let's first test if mass is less than 0, return -1. And we should also check if the height was less than 0, then we are also returning -1. And we didn't have any tests here if the textual presentation should return anything different. But now we could probably test this, and let's see what happens. So we got a compilation error, so possibly lossy conversion from tuple to int. Let's see. And yes, so our tests here say that it should give a value which is in meters. So, and we are taking int here, so we should use double here, of course. And now it's calculated correctly. Let's try again. And the test failed. 50% of the tests failed. So 50 got true, but 50 failed. So we have here two tests, the main test and the calc test. So we are not testing this main. So now we get 100% of failing. Yeah. So what is it telling? It was expecting 24.7, but it got the yeah. So we are not rounding it. So we should do some rounding. Let's go here, and we want to get this as one decimal. So let's do it. Make sure that it stays double, and we use math round this calculation here, and now we get the actual 10 times more, and then round it and then divide it by 10, then we are getting the value. Let's see what happens. So it really failed. Oh yeah, so here we should have also doubles. Yeah. And what has failed? Was expected normal weight, but we got normal, so we are missing here a word. Let's try again. And still failing. No output. Underweight, but was normal weight. So let's see what we were expecting. Underweight. So 60 and 1.8. Let's try it. 60 and 1.8. And this is now working. We got the actual value there because these tests were run and they went through. We are now in the second last test. So it's giving us. No, yeah. So if I remember correctly, I should have put it 58 there now, as that's the border. In the lecture video, I was mentioning this borderline testing. Now the 18.5 is a borderline value. That was the failing. Now the test is passing. So we first wrote tests based on the requirement analysis and the software specification, so that we should have these kind of methods, and they should return values like this, and they should work return minus one, work like this in a case that there is values that are not correct. And after we have created these tests, then we went and developed the actual class and its methods. So we didn't need to write this two times. We first wrote the tests, and then we wrote the code and fixed it until we got those tests to run flawlessly. Now all the tests are passing, so it's working. Good. We could actually this should be divided into two tests. First we test the integer value, and then we test the string value in another test, but now they are all in here. Also there are class variables, but these are not object variables, private variables, but they are not used in anywhere, so this is actually one thing that you could improve this program. But this is just a demonstration what does it mean to do test-driven development. So first we had an idea that we need a body mass calculator, and then we designed a few tests, and then we went and wrote the actual program after those tests have been written.